This is John Cola with Growing Your Greens, and I have a special announcement for you guys. Until May 25th at midnight, I'm offering some t-shirts for you guys. Growing Your Greens official t-shirts, limited time only. I don't know if they'll ever be back again because I'm not in the business of selling t-shirts. I'm here to teach you guys about how to grow your own food. But anyways, you could help me out so that I could buy a farm with my girlfriend and you guys get a t-shirt at the same time. 100% recycled, 100% made in America. They fit me great, that's why I selected them. I've had the same brand t-shirts for over 2 years now, and they wear really well and wash really well and don't rip and all this other kind of stuff. They hold up really well. That's why I'm offering them. Click over right here to get yours today. All right, this is John Cola with GrowingYourGreens.com. Today we have another exciting episode for you here in fabulous Las Vegas, Nevada. I'm here at the Convention Center, and this is the site of the 2016 National Hardware Show. And they also have a big building for the Lawn and Garden Show 2016. So this is the trade event that is open for, like, to, you know, the trade or businesses that resell garden supplies and hardware. So like hardware stores, you know, I probably bumped into some CEOs or execs from Home Depot and didn't even know it. Well, hopefully I didn't bump into them. But anyways, this is like where people go to buy the products that will soon be appearing in the stores. So the products I'll be sharing with you guys, this is like a sneak peek of the latest and greatest gardening products that allow you to grow more food at home. Now, you guys don't understand, like, I'm gonna go in this building here, and this place is huge. It's the size of several football fields. I walked the whole show to find the best booths to share with you guys so that you guys can grow more food at home. Now, I know a lot of you guys, like, John, man, anything you buy, you're in the consumerism society, it's crap, it's bullshit, you shouldn't do it. You could garden with free dirt in your backyard, make your own compost and all this kind of stuff. And hey, that's cool. My goal is to, you know, utilize some of these products that may help you grow a more efficient, higher quality, more nutrient dense, or even just allow somebody new to grow without being intimidated by making it easy. So, you know, there's pros and cons of everything in life, and I know this video will help many people, and I know I'll get a lot of people hemming and hawing about, like, oh, you don't need to buy that crap to grow some stuff. I will say you absolutely don't need any of this crap to grow stuff. That being said, it can be significantly harder and more challenging to grow for it on your own, where some of these products can make it easy. And if one of these products gets a new person that never grew anything before in their life to grow, I've met my goals and my mission for coming to this show today. And that's why I come to these shows, to share with you guys and excite you guys about growing your own food at home, and so that you guys could do it too, damn it. So anyways, let's head into the trade show, show with you guys what it's like, and share with you guys the new and exciting booths I found this year.
So now I'm inside the 2016 hardware show. This is in the lawn and garden area. There's just so many hundreds of booths inside here. This is the size of several football fields. What I'm gonna do next is actually share with you guys my favorite booths this year at the National Hardware Show.
So now I'm inside the show, and I'm gonna share with you guys the first booth. And the first booth I'm gonna share with you guys is right over here. It's actually called the Greenland Gardener. And if you guys check my past episodes, I've been coming to this show since like 2011. I think in 2011, actually made an episode at the Greenland Gardener's booth to share with you guys the products they had, which, you know, have changed a little bit, but not too much. I really like that they have some really cool things happening over there, and that's why I'm filming and sharing this for you guys today. But they got some new innovations and some products that can help you guys out. And this is the only raised bed that I'll be sharing with you guys in this episode today. I mean, I only cover kind of like, when I go to these shows, I only like to cover the newest and latest and greatest stuff. You know, you want to check my past episodes when I come to the show for the latest and greatest stuff of those episodes. I'll put links down below to all the shows since 2011 that I've come to, so that you could, you know, get caught up to speed with all the coolest stuff. Anyways, I want to go ahead and over to Greenland Gardener and share with you guys why I like their raised beds, and actually why I'm filming at their booth today. So the reason why I like the Greenland Gardener products is because, number one, they're made in the USA here, and number two, especially for anybody out there, they're easy to use. These are the easiest raised beds to set up. Even if you don't got any tools, like one of the past videos I just made, assembling a garden with no tools, you don't need any tools to set these guys up. Check it out. If we go back over to this corner here, all you do is you pull these out. This is the corner bracket, and you literally just slide this in. It slides right on. You could assemble one of these beds in like 30 seconds. I personally like the ones that are the 8-inch tall. They also have a smaller 6-inch tall bed. These beds are 4 feet square, and then this guy is just like a little bit off, a little bit less than 4 feet square. And the amazing thing about these beds is that they are inexpensive. So these are available at places like Sam's Club, Home Depot, check their .com online sites. But this guy, for example, is under $30, you know, depending on the price fluctuation. Sometimes it goes as low as $21, $26, you know, whatever, for this bed right here. And here's the tip, order from HomeDepot.com. They have free shipping over $45. So order two of these raised beds for like, I don't know, $46. You'll get free shipping. And let me tell you, these guys, to ship them like 22 pounds, that ain't cheap. I don't know how Home Depot makes any money if you're buying two and you're getting free shipping on them. Right, assemble it, fill with some good soil, dirt, compost from your local Home Depot. Be sure to check my past episodes for my recommendations on that, because you don't want to just get any cheap old dirt. And then you're up and growing. Super simple, super easy. Now, the reason why I brought you guys here is actually the next bed over that I want to show you guys something really cool that actually I never seen before. So the reason why I stopped at the Greenland Gardener today is because as I walked the show, which I walked the whole entire thing, so you guys don't have to, they got these guys. They got some little basically seats for the raised bed. Now this is their Greenland Gardener raised bed garden kit with two movable benches. This one's made out of 100% wood. This is pine wood with a nice stain on it. You know, retails for about $80. It's not gonna last more than maybe 2-3 years, depending. That's why I like their plastic beds, but even their plastic beds contain more wood than plastic. The plastic beds are 60% wood, hardwood, with 40% of the HDPE, which is the best plastic to use for, you know, gardening products. But anyways, these guys, why I stopped is because they have these little benches, right? And these benches, they come with two. You could like put, you know, your plants you're gonna be potting out, or if you're older and you don't wanna like bend down and crouch over like I like to do, you can just sit on these little benches and work your raised bed. Super ingenious. And for those of you guys that aren't gonna buy their raised bed garden kit, check it out. These things are super simple, super easy to make. Everybody should make these. And it's just basically, you know, a bracket with a little, a hook here on the end. Super ingenious. Everybody should invent one of these. I kinda like these actually personally better than putting like the ledges on your raised bed, because I find if you like, you know, put the fascia board on the top little ledge, you know, like snails and slugs will hide up underneath the bed and you can't see them. And so this way you could actually have a place to sit and you could remove it, you could sit there, you could leave it out there. It's just super cool. And I like the folks at Greenland Gardening because they keep up to date, right? They follow my YouTube channel. They check out Instagram and Facebook, Pinterest and all them things all the time to see the latest and newest innovations. And when they see something new and different, they'll start incorporating that into their products so that this increases and makes it easier for people to grow their own food at home. So yeah, check out Greenland Gardener, made in the USA, available at places like Sam's Club, Home Depot, and maybe even Walmart. So now I want to show you guys my favorite booth at this whole entire event. It's actually right here. It doesn't look like much. They got a sign, they got a table, and they got, you know, a little display there. But this booth actually has the best product for the cheapest price that's going to do the most for your gardening. Yeah, you could build a raised bed and you could buy all these other things that I'm going to show you guys. But for just 10 bucks, you're going to be able to make the biggest change in your garden you've ever seen. So let me go ahead and go over to Garden Treasure and explain to you guys this $10 product that's going to change the life of your garden. So this is the booth of Garden Treasure, and yes, it does not look like much, but this is one of the booths when I did my preliminary research for coming to the show. I search the online exhibitors to find out the booths that I'm really interested in. You know, I search things like compost and beneficial bacteria and organic fertilizers and all this kind of stuff, and I find the Garden Treasure little entry, and I'm like, oh man, this is one of the booths I really got to find. So when I was walking down the aisle, I saw, oh, that's the booth I've really been looking for, right? And so this is it, and it's just really not much. And what they're selling are these little $10 packets. This is a $10 packet right there. Like, you're like, John, man, I could buy like 3 coffees at Starbucks for 10 bucks. I know what you're also thinking now. John, have you gone to Starbucks lately? You can't buy 3 coffees for 10 bucks. It's like 8 bucks a coffee or the lattes or whatever, right? Well, anyways, these guys are 10 bucks because they're printed on there, so you can't get that wrong. But I mean, this looks like a little sugar packet. Sugar packets are a dime a dozen, and actually, they're really that cheap. But these guys They're 10 bucks, so that's really inexpensive, but there's a lot in here. There's millions of microbes in here. And, you know, this is one of the fundamentals of my gardening style, which is, you know, the soil minerals and the microbes. And the microbes are critical. You know, there's some people out there, oh, things like compost tea, they don't work, and, you know, you need good compost. And the reason why the compost and the compost tea works, in my opinion, is because the specialized microbes that are in there. Now, the challenge with compost and compost teas is they might not have the right microbes in there. You're just kind of like, it's kind of like, actually, when I came here, because I parked in a place that said, this parking is only good for people that are like customers of this resort, you know, hotel thing. So I'm like, okay, man, I don't want to get towed. So I actually went inside, broke a five, put a dollar in the slot machine, and then I hit the button. And guess what? Out of a dollar, I won 2 cents. What a ripoff. But anyways, I'm a customer, so if they tow me, I'm gonna say, you bastard, you can't tow me, I'm a customer. I spent a 98 cents in your casino. But anyways, when you roll and play the slot machines, you probably ain't gonna win. And when you gamble with the compost and you're buying bag compost from Home Depot or you're making your own compost tea, you don't know the kind of microbes that are in there. You may hit the jackpot or you probably won't, like the odds at the casino here. But when you guys buy this, you are getting guaranteed analysis of specific microbes. Actually, there's over 50 different kinds of microbes, beneficial bacteria, and fungi in here that they've researched over the years. And the reason why I like this specifically, especially me living in the desert, is because desert microbes have to be some of the hardiest microbes out there. The desert microbes, they don't get rain for like, you know, months at a time sometimes. So they have to live in a harsh desert environment. And those are the microbes that are in here, desert microbes. But then when there's water and the desert microbes, they go nuts, man. They like replicate really fast because it's like, holy shit, we're gonna run out of water in like a couple days, so we better do our work now before the water goes away. So they're much more virulent and tolerant, and they're gonna work harder for you. And those are the microbes in here, as well as a lot of other kinds. So I don't know, this is like just some of the microbes in there, and this is all fully researched through universities, and they got studies on this. I looked it up last night, and I mean, that's why I really like this. These are microbes that you're not gonna get anywhere else for just simply 10 bucks, amazing. So actually, I got a sample the other day when I was here, and I applied it in my garden. I basically filled up my backpack spray with 2 gallons of water, put this stuff in there, mixed it up, and I pumped up my backpack spray, and then went around my garden. Now this thing, I think, handles like 1,000 square feet of garden space. And you know, my garden's, I don't know, probably bigger than that actually. So anyways, I filled this up and went around. I was only able to hit half my backyard garden with this stuff. I basically went around and drenched the soil with it. And that's how easy it is to apply. And they say in just as short as 2 weeks, like 15 days, maybe 30 days, you're gonna see a difference. And the difference is you'll see, you're probably gonna see bigger roots. This is pretty much a given. So if you did like one plant without this and one plant with it, you will see a difference in roots, because in the size of the roots, because that's what the microbes do. They really colonize the root zone. They break down the organic matter in the soil and make it bioavailable for the plants so that they'll grow faster, bigger, and be healthier. Now, because you're going to have healthier plants, that means they will also be more pest and disease resistant. So they said here, you know, if you use this stuff, you won't have any pest problems. And, you know, I take a lot of things out here with a grain of salt, and I'm confident that if your plants are healthier, you'll have less pests. And I don't know that they're all going to go away, but I wanted to get this in my soil as soon as possible to see if all my aphid problem goes away. That'd simply be amazing. Now the other thing with the microbes, right, especially you live in the desert, you don't want to just mix this stuff up and spray it, you know, in the middle of August or July when it's 100 degrees out, because the water that's carrying the microbes is going to evaporate, then they're not really going to have a home to live in. So you want to, you know, mix it up and spray it out at dusk, you know, so you can still see what you're doing, but not in the middle of the day, so they'll have the whole night to acclimate, to kind of move and get in the soil and do what they're ever going to do. I don't know what microbes do. But and then they'll be more effective for you guys. Now, the other thing I like to do is I want you guys to use when you apply this stuff, use filtered water. Don't just use chlorinated tap water, right? Or even worse than chlorine in your tap water. You know, they're using things like chloramines, which are even something more nasty. You guys want to use some filtered water to spray this stuff out, because the chlorine in the water may lower the bacterial counts. And I want to increase the bacterial counts in my garden. Now, another tip I want to share with you guys is simply this. I did talk at length because I have heard that microbes can be damaged using pump sprayers. And so they have a research here that anything over 40 PSI is bad. But if it's up to 20 or up to 40 PSI, you're not over that. So I would maybe use like 20, but a standard pump sprayer is not going to get that high. It's not going to really affect and burst the microbes. The other thing you could do if you don't have a pump sprayer to apply this stuff, you could also use a watering can, but then you're probably going to have to buy more of this stuff because you're not going to get a really good spread as easily. It's not going to go as far. Now they have these, I don't want to say dumb, $10 packets, and most people, you know, that you guys watch me may not have a garden over 1,000 feet, but I do, and I know a lot of you guys that are really serious about growing your own food do also. So that's why you'd want to get this packet, and this packet treats an acre. It's a much better value than the $10 packet. This is about $50, and this will treat your whole garden. And this stuff, once you open it, will last a little bit over a year, so you can get by with treating your stuff this year and then treating it next year. You know, for me personally, I'm going to treat my garden about every 6 months with this stuff, you know, just to ensure that I have high levels of microbes, because that's one of the fundamentals that I teach, and unfortunately, most gardeners don't even teach this stuff. You know, and every time I go to one of these trade shows and talk to people, I learn something new. And the thing I learned here is they teach the four M's. And these are some of the things I teach also. They teach moisturization, so that makes sure your plants and your soil has the right moisture. Mineralization, so make sure you got the trace minerals in there, whether that's through a C90 product or rock dust product, or whether that's through some kind of other sea solids. They teach micronization, so that means make sure the particle size of whatever you're putting in your garden, like you're putting rock dust, it wants to be fine particle rock dust, not pea gravel. You know, if you're going to put in some biochar, small pieces of biochar, that's where the microbes are going to live, not just big, you know, charcoal briquettes, which you shouldn't be putting in your garden anyways. Those are like too huge. And then the other thing is the microbization or microbes. You want to have microbes in there anyways. And these are the things I teach. I think kind of teach the three basics because I kind of take for granted you got some moisture and, you know, you're using some rock dust, which is already micronized. But yeah, I mean, the things I teach are definitely the trace minerals. I want you guys also to have organic matter, which is beneficial not only for the microbes, but also for some, materials or fibrous materials in there. And then also, of course, I teach the microbes, very important. So yeah, best $10 you could spend if you got a small garden, like a couple beds, or yeah, I definitely encourage you guys to get the large pack, about $50, treat your whole yard. I mean, and yeah, they got a little brochure of like all the things that this product could do. Increase brix levels, that's very important. If you guys want the sweetest tomatoes on your block, this is the product you're gonna wanna use. You're gonna, have 20 tons of A-grade aerobic compost applied 2 times a year for 5 years would only accomplish half of what Garden Treasure will do in just 30 days. This is the power of this product. I mean, there's a lot of YouTube gardeners say, just use compost, right? I think they're full of it, right? They don't know the information that I know, right? And these are desert microbes, and they have, they create enzymes and metabolites. I mean, and it says, check this out, visual variance. In under 30 days, your customers will see the established root increase by 100 to 400%. Not even fertilizer gives this type of root growth in this time frame. So, I mean, you'll see the proof once you use this stuff. And check it out, bigger roots means the plants could basically take up more nutrients, which means they're gonna be bigger. So yeah, that's really important to me. So I've been thinking, John, you know, I really like you, but man, you're kind of high on this video, which I'm not. It's $10 for this little packet. How could this little packet be worth $10? Well, it contains microbes, and you're like, my compost app has microbes, and my compost tea has microbes. You know, how can these microbes be any better? Well, these microbes are different microbes and in different concentrations than other microbial products. I've used other microbial products before, and I really believe in them and believe you guys should add them to your garden. But you know, you're basically kind of gambling like I did earlier and lost, right? In your compost, you're not gonna have the CFUs or colony forming units. And just like in 48 hours doing this properly applied, you're gonna have like over 100,000 colony forming units of the microbes in there. And we wanna increase these colony forming units because these are your free labor force. You know, the more colony forming units, the more bacteria in there, the more shit is gonna happen in your garden so your plants could, you know, make more nutrients and the whole system could work better. And that's why I really like this stuff. Now I'm still working and testing on it, and I'll have updated videos maybe applying this stuff and how my garden's growing, because I've been growing for a number of years without this particular microbial product, and I'm really interested in seeing if it's really gonna make a difference. Maybe I'll even do some trials where I plant two plants, one with this stuff and one with it, and show you guys the root increase or not increase. But at this time, I mean, because this product is from farm grade, I mean, this has been used on farms for many number of years, like big industrial farms, they know this stuff works. So that's why I have confidence and faith in it. Now they're just making it in a smaller size so that the home gardeners could benefit from it too. So yeah, be sure to click that subscribe button right down below for future episodes that I do on the Garden Treasure product. And if you want to get your own, they're at agardentreasure.com. So now I'm going to share with you guys another booth here that I like a lot. Actually, we're at the Haxnicks booth. And Haxnicks, for those of you guys that are in the UK, would know that brand. It's a major garden brand over there, but we don't know them here in the, all us Yanks here in the US don't know about the Haxnicks company. It's distributed in the USA and is available on Amazon by Tierra and distributed to other retailers by TDI. Anyways, let's go ahead and go in the little flower house thing and show the guys the cool product that I really like at Haxnicks. So now I'm gonna go ahead and walk into this small sun bubble, which is really cool because it's actually nice and large. So if you wanna start your plants out earlier in the season, maybe grow a little bit later before the frost comes, this would be excellent. I mean, it goes together like one of those little tents and super easy and convenient to put up and take down and pack down. Now, I don't know if I'd leave this up year round because this plastic stuff might not like last in like the direct sun. Plus you don't want to have it out in the middle of summertime. Maybe if you lived in the UK because it's so cold, you might need it. I don't know, I haven't been there in a while. But anyways, besides this product, they have a lot of other cool little products like my first vegetable garden. And these are basic, here's a really cool one. Lantern cloche. You know, these are very important to keep bugs off your plants. You know, you could spray pesticides and all this toxic stuff. I don't recommend that. Keep the bugs out. Why do you guys lock your house at night, right? You don't want the burglars to come in. So, you know, build a house over your plants so that the bugs won't get in, especially like things like squash, borer, viners, and all these things that I don't got, right? Anyways, let's go ahead and head inside and check out the cool product I want to show you. So Haxnicks has a lot of cool different gardening products. I mean, I could sit here all day and go over like, oh man, these are little garden cloches to put over your plants to keep them warmer if you have little seedlings in the springtime that are coming out, but you're planting a little bit too early. I mean, they got to do these things over in the UK with their shorter growing season. You know, they're not having. They have all kinds of other lantern cloches that go over big areas, and you know, they got. I don't know, I could pick up all kinds. Oh, this is cool, bird tape. They got all kinds of crazy stuff and it's all available on Amazon. But the thing that I really want to show you guys today is this. It's the rapid root trainers or deep root trainers. And that's what this guy is right here. This comes as a kit for you guys. And this is a great way to start off your seedlings. And this has been used for a number of years over in the UK. And you know, when they do like big agroforestry, like replanting trees and all this kind of stuff, this is a thing they use. Because, you know, besides having like a little starting tray to start your plants out, which is really cool, and this is excellent if you guys do any kind of like trees and germinating tree seeds, you know, you want them to have long tap roots. And what you do in this kit right here, you could take out a four pack and you basically fill this up with your soil, and then you put your, you know, tree seed in there, or your cutting, and then basically because these are long, they root down long. You know, this is why I don't like some of those six packs, because you know, they're kind of short, and you could use your vegetables in here, especially vegetables with like deep tap roots. So I don't know, for some reason, dandelion comes to mind. Start your dandelion here, and basically what's gonna happen is it's gonna grow all the way down to the bottom. When the bottom, these are kind of open air, it's gonna get air root pruned, and the root's gonna get, oh, there's air, I don't wanna grow there. Let's start another root and send another root down. So then when, you know, after your plants are started and grown well, they're gonna have nice deep tap roots going down deep. And then when you wanna get them out, right, instead of trying to like fiddle it out and squeeze this and all this stuff, check this out. You could take this and it opens right up. So now you could get your plants out damage free. You know, so many times when I've been dealing with six packs, actually just my girlfriend was planting some plants out and she didn't get it all outright, and there's like roots and soil still left in the six pack. But with this, you'd open it up and you can be able to take the whole thing out. And that's just really cool. I really like it a lot. So whether you're doing trees or like vegetables with long tap roots, I always want to encourage you guys to grow the healthiest plants. And I believe with the rapid root trainers, you'll be able to do just that. So if you're looking for Haxnicks in the US, I haven't really seen them in any garden centers. Hopefully someone will be picking them up, but check out Amazon for the Rapid Root Trainer. Hopefully I'll be using this real soon, especially if I'm doing trees and other crops with deep roots. So one of the reasons why I love coming to these shows is because I get to see products that are from all over the world here in Las Vegas, Nevada. What we're looking at now is actually the Great Britain and Ireland Pavilion with all the different sellers of gardening products from there right here to share their wares with the U.S. market. I've actually found one booth that I really like a lot, so let's go ahead and head over there and show you guys what they got. So my favorite booth in the whole Britain area is right here. It's actually a Wildlife World UK, and they don't have necessarily anything to grow your food here, but they have something that will assist greatly in growing your food. And what that is right here. And let me go ahead and do some close-ups for you guys. They got solitary beehives and basically creating habitats for beneficial insects in your garden. So let's take a look at them. So Wildlife World UK has a lot of different products to attract the beneficial insects in your garden, including the solitary beehive and the big insect biome and all these other things. And basically, here's the thing. You know, as much as we like honeybees and honeybees do some of the pollinating, the solitary bees, mason bees, and other bees will pollinate 85% more than just the honeybees. So I want to encourage you guys, all you guys out there, to make some habitat for the beneficial bees and the other beneficial insects that we'll be talking about in a second. You know, they will increase your guys' production, and they are losing habitat. You know, they're bulldozing, you know, forests and putting up houses and stuff, and these bees don't have a place to live. And you could easily solve this problem by having a home for them to help them out. And guess what? Nature is reciprocal. They will help you out as well. Man, unfortunately, is not reciprocal. We just go in there and destroy stuff, and we're not helping too many things, unfortunately, in my opinion. And this company's there to change that. And you know, there's a lot of different mason bee houses and all this kind of stuff out there, but I'm gonna show you guys why I like the solitary beehive more than the other ones I've seen, because it's interactive. If you're a curious adult like myself, or you have kids, this is the solitary beehive you're gonna wanna buy. I mean, basically a solitary beehive, it's not much. You could take some 2x4 and drill the right size holes in there, and the bees will nest. So just everybody should do this, like, no doubt. But if you want to make it more interactive, they got this set up right here. It's got the holes in there, but the cool thing is this one comes apart, so you could actually see the life cycle and the stages of the solitary bees. So it's like this basically, and on the bottom you got these little thumb screws. You take these little thumb screws off, and then basically what happens is this thing comes off in pieces, and then you'll be able to see in there, you know, what the bees are doing, you know, their little eggs and all this kind of stuff as they're growing. So that's really cool. Now, the thing is this, John, will that thing work if I actually put it up at my house? And I'll tell you guys, I had a solitary bee house before, like a plastic one with these like, you know, little like paper tube things. I put it up and nothing came, right? Well, the owner here said that, you know, 99.9% of the time, if you put one of these guys up, and that's the big keyword, and and you got a solitary bees where you live, like I'm out in my garden, I see all these little small bees going around in my flowers, so I got them. If you put it in the right place at the right time and all this kind of stuff, they will populate this and increase in their numbers, and you will gain the benefits. So here's the tips. If you guys are going to place one of these guys, you guys want to place it below shoulder level, number one. Very important. When I place mine, I'm like, oh, that would be a convenient place for me to put it, like up on the eaves of my house. That was too high. The other thing that's very important is you want to put this somewhere not in full direct sun. That's not good. You want to have a little bit of morning sun in there, like when the sun rises, it should be shining on this. And then in the afternoon, you don't want sun shining. It's, you know, a place where sun don't shine. And that's not when you're wearing pants. Anyways, but yeah, so that's how it's going to work. And once you do that, it will work. Now, besides just a solitary bee hive that they have this guy. And this guy's really cool too, because it's the insect biome. Besides having places for the solitary bees and actually like a little viewing port, so this is actually clear tube, you could pull this out and kind of look in there, see what's going on. They got places for butterflies, and other creatures. They have a little feeding station for beneficial insects and butterflies. And then check this out. You turn it to the side. This is totally clear. So it's like one of those like beehives that you could kind of look in. You could see like all the things that are going on in there. And this may attract things like green lacewings, which are very effective at like eating some of the bad insects, you know, the ladybugs. Also, you know, of course, the beneficial solitary bees, the pollinators, and other insects and creatures. Like this bottom area is meant for creatures that actually break down organic matter, like earwigs and all these other things, to get in there, because those are the recyclers, the earwigs and all these things. They break down all the decayed organic matter and turn that into more fertilizer for your plants. You know, these products are available here in the US on Amazon, amongst other places. You can check them out at wildlifeworld.co.uk for more information. Now I'm gonna share with you guys another booth. It's actually called the Darwin's Garden Guide to Healthy Plants. And this is just one of those like ideas that you kind of wish you would have came up with. So let's check it out. So this is Darwin's Garden. And what it simply is, it was actually made by a gardener who actually had some challenges with growing some tomatoes. And the problem he had some kind of disease. And then he's like getting out his iPhone or the little books and trying to like go to page and like kind of look like, oh, is it this thing? Is it this thing? Is it this thing? And it's kind of like inconvenient. So he came up with an idea that he just did for himself to make like, and use in his own garden. He basically just, you know, took all the pictures for different situations. So for example, in this situation, it's plant deficiencies. If your leaves look like this, what is it? I mean, that's one of the questions I get like all the time. John, my pepper leaves are yellow. What does that mean? Well, where is it yellow? Is it yellow around the rim? Are there yellow spots? I mean, I can't like, you tell me your plant's leaves are yellow. I'm not gonna know what the hell's going on, right? But here, what they did was they have actually detailed pictures. Okay, if your leaves are yellow, right here, it means it's nitrogen deficient. This happens to me and my peppers when I plant them for two reasons. Maybe if there's not like enough watering, because then the plants can't take up the nitrogen, or maybe because I need to maybe add and hit it with some nitrogen because they're going into transplant shock, hit them with some kelp or something like that. You know, here's a phosphorus deficiency, here's a potassium deficiency, magnesium deficiency. This is the chart you guys will need to know, you'll need to have, so that you could find the deficiency and be like, oh, you could compare it easily. You could take the leaf and look at the leaf on here. And the cool thing is, he chose to use as the model leaf, it's kind of like that swimsuit model. The model leaf is a tomato leaf, which is the most grown vegetable for home gardeners. So you can see on a tomato leaf how it looks. But even if it's being shown on a tomato leaf, pepper leaves will look the same way, you know, just a little bit different, you know, because the pepper leaf doesn't look like the tomato leaf, but the signs of deficiencies will look the same. So besides just the plant deficiencies that he goes over here, he has nitrogen deficiency. And then on the back, you could see what it looks like and read about it. Then on the back, he tells you the organic method you can correct this deficiency. Now, besides just having the one on the plant deficiencies, he has ones on the plant diseases. So this is another huge one. Once again, on a tomato plant, you can see here. And they have things like black spot and rust and early blight and downy mildew. I mean, all these things you guys could see there, they look a little bit different. And if you guys got this chart and you're in your garden, these are laminated really nice. So like you could hang it out in your tool shed, you know, leave it outside to get wet. If you leave these guys out and it's raining, these are gonna be fine. They're totally laminated, totally protected. Man, you could like take this and tie it right next to your tomato plants if you guys wanted to, and leave it outside for the season to like be able to, so you don't lose it. Because if I had some of these things, they might get lost in my office. But yeah, you can see powdery mildew, late blight, leaf curl, mosaic virus, root rot, club root, all these things, algae, rust, blossom, end rot. Yeah, blossom end rot, that's a huge one. And then on the back, they have all the standard you know, ways, or organic ways to get rid of this, and things that are available at a local nursery or big box store near you, including some of my favorite things like neem and Dr. Bronner soap. So this is the plant diseases. And then let's see, oh, the other big one for people. John, I got this bug in my garden, man. What kind of bug is it? And so he has identifying all the bugs and pests, good ones and bad ones. And then also on the back, how to take care of them. And these guys are affordably priced. I think they're around $10 retail. But you know, I look out for you guys. I want you guys to have these charts because I believe with the set of three charts, this is gonna help you guys be more effective so you guys will get less disease, you'll be able to identify bugs, and you'll know when your plants are deficient in something. So I negotiated a special, buy two, get one free, right? And then also I negotiated hard to get you guys this deal, free shipping. So this guy saves you. This saves you guys a ton of money. So I encourage every you guys watching this to get this chart, especially if you're growing tomatoes or California tomatoes, as my friend Josh would say, because these charts and diseases and pests will apply to every plant, not just the tomatoes. So if you want to learn more about this, you're going to want to check the link down below to the Facebook page for the special link to get this special promotional offer. And if you're not gonna take me up on this offer, that's all right. Look for these at a local garden store or online near you. Once again, this is Darwin's Garden. So now I'm at the Hydro Farm booth. And if you guys are into hydroponics, you guys will know Hydro Farm. They're a big manufacturer and distributor of a lot of different hydroponic products. But if you guys are gardeners, you guys should definitely know about Hydro Farm, because even if you're not growing hydroponically, even if you're growing in the dirt or other stuff, Hydro Farm has a lot of different accessories that'll help you guys out garden. Matter of fact, I actually have their seed starting mat myself, and I have actually their air bubbler to make my compost tea, and their pump, active aqua pumps. They got all kinds of cool stuff. But I want to share with you guys the two most important products at their whole booth today. And let's go over there and check it out. So while Hydro Farm has tons of different products to allow you to grow food at home, these are the ones I like the most at their whole booth today. And there's tons of other stuff that I don't have the time to cover, but these are the most important for me to share with you guys. This, the first one is called this. This is the soil-free growing salad box. This is a passive hydroponic system. Now, for those of you guys that have been watching me over the years, you guys will know that I covered this system last year at this show, and be sure to check the links down below to my previous year shows. Here, I've been coming to this show since 2011 making videos, but at the last show, you know, they were available over in the UK, but I'm glad that Hydro Farm now picked it up as probably one of the largest distributors in the hydroponics industry, so that these guys are now available for you guys in the US. You know, one of my things is that I want everybody in the US to be able to grow their own food. And a lot of you guys, I know, you guys don't have a yard. You might live in an apartment. But now with the soil-free growing salad box, you guys could grow inside your house year-round salad. And it couldn't be any easier. You buy this, it's about a $40 retail price. Oops, and we're losing the fake lettuce. And what happens is you guys fill this up with water, and the special hydroponic solution that they actually did lots of trials with to get it right. You know, if you just use any old hydro solution, it may not grow the highest and best quality lettuce, and you may have problems and challenges. They've done a lot of R&D to even make this better than the version in the UK to work properly, because Hydro Farm are the hydroponic experts. And so they've dialed this in so that literally you set this up, you put in water, make sure it's clean water. You know, I'd recommend using some like RO water, distilled water. Don't use that tap water, right? And fill this up, put the nutrient solution in there, and then all you need to do is, you know, put in a nice sunny window. I'd actually get some additional lighting on it, maybe their Hydro Farm's jump start system. That'd be incredible. You know, the more light you can get on the lettuce, the faster it's gonna grow, right? And then you'll be able to harvest your own lettuce inside without doing anything. There's no pumps or anything. Super simple. And then you'll be able to turn lettuce and grow your own lettuce year round. Simply amazing. So anyways, let's go ahead and go to the next one that I wanna show you guys. This is the OxyClone. And you know, I'm really glad that Hydro Farm picked up this product, but more importantly than picked it up, they improved it. So the original OxyClone, actually, I have a video of it. I don't know, maybe I'll put a link down below if I remember. And it was from a company that were just like, they had their heads up there, you know what, right? But Hydro Farm picked it up, and they don't have their heads up there, but they basically improved this, made it better, and it's even better than ever, and they have different sizes now. So what this product allows you to do, it allows you to clone your plants, whether you're growing medicinal plants, you know, things like culinary herbs or other things, you know, basils, mints. You know, I clone my Janura Procumbens in here. It allows you to clone it really simple and easy. And then inside, they have their award-winning active aqua pumps, their air stones, and they have all these little foam little things, you know, that keep the plants in place. This is probably the best cloner you're gonna wanna get at the lowest price, and this is especially important for people that are into home gardening. This is a way you could keep your special plants like the genera procum bens, that's a highly medicinal known as the longevity spinach, growing during the winter, you know, right before the end of the season and before you're gonna get your frost, take cuttings. You put the cuttings in here just like this, stick it down a little bit, run this thing, and it's gonna grow roots. When the roots get pretty big, then you're gonna wanna take these guys out and pot them up and then have them underneath, you know, some lights in your house and grow them out. And then you could, like, you know, clone other plants. So this allows you to keep your plants alive year round, even if you don't live in a climate that you could grow some of these tropicals that I like. You know, another thing I'm gonna be hopefully growing in this really soon is my katuk. I love growing katuk, another sensitive tropical that you could clone in the winter, have it grow, and then plant it out in the summer. You'll also be able to share your rooted plants with friends and neighbors, and I know even people using these to sell them online, right, to make a little business out of it and get these very important, valuable plants out to people. If you want to learn more about these products, you want to check out hydrofarm.com, but if you want to buy these products, visit a local hydroponics store near you. Most all hydroponic stores, unless they got their heads up there, you know what, are selling Hydro Farm stuff and can get it for you guys if they don't have it in stock. So you guys can get the salad box and the OxyClone. So now I want to share with you guys another cool booth here at the trade show that I like a lot for certain reasons, but don't like for other reasons. Now, you know, one of the things is in this video, guys, you're seeing all kinds of new products, and this is absolutely a new product that I've never seen before, and it's gonna help a lot of you guys, you know, especially if you're a beginner, novice gardener, live in a big city, you don't have acreage, and you want it simple and easy because you don't have a lot of time to play and dig in the dirt and plant transplants and all this kind of stuff, right? And this is what it is. It's actually called the seed sheet. And so they make planting out a raised bed, a small garden box, or even row crops way simple. So I think the technology is amazing. I just have some challenges with maybe a little bit pricey. So let's go ahead and find out what they're selling at Home Depot now and how much it costs. So what they're now selling at the Home Depot in the New York City and Seattle area is this. This is actually displayed from Home Depot. And they got two seed sheets. They got a 12 by 36 for salad or herbs, and they got a seed sheet garden kit, 4x8 large raised bed, veggie or tomatoes. And what you're gonna get for your $74.98 is a bag like this. It's a lot of money for just a little small bag. But what you're doing is you're paying for convenience. And this is a seed sheet. And inside this bag is basically the sheet, which is the weed fabric, with pre-impregnated seeds at the proper square foot gardening spacing, so you could easily grow a weed-free garden. I know a lot of people hate weeding, and they'll pay a little bit extra money so that they'll have a weed-free garden without having to weed. You also get some stakes to secure this down, and in this package they're growing lettuce, green beans, snap peas, carrots, and Tuscan kale, over 50 plants. They also have a kit with tomatoes here. And they got sweet basil, glacier tomato, Moscovich tomato, and golden tomato. And the cool thing about this package is this package and this company is out of Vermont, where they have a short growing season. So they've selected certain varieties of organic seeds to put in their packages. So even in a short season, you guys are gonna get maximum yields and maximum returns on what you're growing. So, I mean, I'm kind of still stuck on the price, like $75 for like 50 plants. Like, I'd rather buy some plant starts. Now, if you're buying plant starts at Home Depot, it could cost $350 per plant, which could actually get quite costly. That'd be way more than $75, but I like to get my 4-inch pots on average for around $1, maybe $1.50 at the most. So, you know, that would probably be right around $75 anyways. And then I got to dig them up, plant them up, but then I'm getting a head start. I mean, there's pros and cons of this system here. Let me go ahead and show you guys what this looks like. So, I mean, this is like the large 4-foot by 8-foot, and basically it's just the weed fabric, and this is huge. This is the 4-foot by 8-foot. I'm like, hey, do you guys have a 4-foot by 4-foot? Because 4-foot by 4-foot is like much more common than the 4-foot by 8-foot. And they're like, no, we just got the 4-foot by 8-foot. And he's like, oh, we have a 4-foot circular one. I'm like, no, well, if you got a square garden, but you can't put a circular one in there because the weeds are gonna come up where you don't have the weed fabric. But the thing you could do is you could take the 4-foot by 8-foot, cut it in half, and plant 2 4-foot by 4-foots. Anyways, it gets kind of complex. But anyways, this is a really heavy duty weed fabric that also is recyclable. And how they do this actually is they put the soil in there and the seeds with everything you need to go. You need to add fertilizer later. And it's in one of those like little packs, Like last year at this expo, I saw a company selling these as like instead of seed bombs or like seed bombs, but they didn't impregnate it in a fabric. I really like how they took that idea and then impregnate it in fabric so that now you could water these and then these will dissolve, kind of like those things in your dishwasher, the little gel packs. The seeds are gonna germinate and then grow in the areas at the right spacing. So the other thing they're doing at the seed sheets company, besides the garden kits and the windowsill kits, they're gonna be doing bucket kits. And this is really cool, including the little seed sheet that goes right into a 5 gallon bucket that you could source yourself. They're gonna have a whole kit for like under $20. So now you could set these up on your outside patio and grow a bunch of food. Like in this one, they got a tomato. It's probably from this one right here. Actually, this is a sunflower. And you can also have a little herb garden. So this just makes gardening more convenient and easy for people that don't know how to, you know, start their seeds, what the right mixture to use and all this kind of stuff. Put this in there, water it, and you're off and growing. I mean, I really like that they're just making it a lot easier for people that may be intimidated growing, which you guys should not be intimidated. If you're intimidated growing, check my other videos. I'll definitely fill you full of some motivation. Anyways, let's go ahead and show you guys a few more products here at the Seed Sheet booth. So what we're looking at now is their 1 foot by 3 foot seed kit. And this is the same one that's available at the Home Depots in the certain regions and also available homedepot.com as well as the manufacturer's, the seed sheets website. And it allows you to grow like a very simple window box. And you just lay this out, you put the weed fabric down, you know, you water them and then the plants come up. So over here, I think this stuff is dill. We got some parsley, cilantro, and basil. So this is the real easy way to do it. You lay this down, you water it, the little things dissolve, and then basically the plants grow up, and then you're not gonna have weeds, and it's nice black weed cloth. And that's how it works. I mean, this is the setup here with the larger bed kit, and this is how it looks. And yeah, I mean, that's the whole thing. I mean, this is kind of cool because it just makes gardening easy for people. And like, I'm not here to like show you guys like, oh, I'm not gonna show that product because I think it's a little bit expensive. I know there's some of you guys out there that like, man, John, that's the best idea because I'm not gonna garden because of the weeds, you know, and I got extra money because I'm I get paid multi-million dollars at my job and I could buy a $75 mat. That's cool. I'm just here to show you with you guys and any company that is actually teaching people how to grow their own food and even making it easier, I definitely wanna promote and hopefully, you know, they're really successful with this. Now, the thing I really like, more than just like the raised bed garden, the thing that I really like is for farmers. So imagine this, you're a row crop farmer, right? You got your rows and you wanna plant every like 2 feet your tomato plants, right? And then you got weeds in your fields, right? This is a huge problem with farmers, especially because labor is expensive. Now they could make one that like to your custom size and specifications, you know, for your row size, you could cover your mound and have the seeds of the plants you want. They could custom manufacture this in the USA, in Vermont, in their factory, and then send it out to you. You guys just unfurl it, weed cloth with pre-impregnated seeds, water it, they dissolve, and then you have plants, you have the weed cloth already installed. I mean, that's really where I see this technology going, and the more these guys they could sell retail, the cheaper they could get the price, and then I think maybe this is a real viable thing. I think, you know, in the proper application, this is great technology, and I think it should be available everywhere. So if you wanna learn more about them, you wanna visit them at seedsheets.com. So now I'm gonna show you guys probably one of my other favorite booths here at this trade show this year. It's actually the Good Ideas Company, and you know, I've passed by their booth pretty much every year since 2011, maybe 2010, since I come into these things. And this year I actually stopped because actually they're taking a notice of what I'm doing and taking my suggestions to make better products. And I think this is what every company should do, you know, whether that's an American car company or whatever. We all need to always increase and make things better and more importantly, make them in America. So let's go head over to Good Ideas and show you guys what they got that I'm so excited about. So while Good Ideas makes all different kinds of products like pet kennels and deck storage and water storage and raised bed gardens, what I'm really here to show you guys today is their brand new composter. No, not the one on that side. You know, I really don't like that design. That was like maybe last year's model. And like with the barrel composters, they're sitting vertically like that, they get so heavy to spin because they get bottom heavy. too hard to spin. So like, I don't know why they came up with that one, but I made some suggestions in a video and through some emails. And this is what they came up with. They took my favorite composter, which is the drawer form composter, designed in Sweden, made in China, and even made it better here in the good old USA. So let me go ahead and share with you guys this prototype model that'll hopefully be available third quarter 2016. So here is their composter, and it is huge. Check it out, there's one side here, one side over here. This will compost a total of 14 cubic feet. So it's like 7 cubic feet per side. And you know, I really like the horizontal access composters because the weight's more evenly distributed. They're a lot easier to spin. And the other thing about this that differs it from every other composter that's being sold on the market virtually, except maybe the Jura, is that it has built-in insulation. This is like that spray-in insulation. So they make the plastic thing and then they insulate it. What does this mean to you? This means faster compost times. This means hotter temperatures inside. This means you're able to compost in the snow if you live in Alaska in the winter or maybe even in the summer. But yeah, so nice and heavy duty. You know, one of the challenges I saw with the Jura insulation is that they just basically use this padding, this foam padding on the inside, and it gets kind of funny and things kind of get in between the metal and the insulation. And it's not like, I mean, it works, but like this is an improvement because the insulation is totally hidden inside the plastic panel. So I really like that a lot. Now the other thing that they've done a lot better than the drawer, they took the drawer to the next level because I'm sure they watched the video where I, you know, demonstrated the drawer and made my suggestions on what the drawer company should do. Drawer didn't do that, but this company did because, you know, they're trying to basically make things better here in America and they've done it. They basically made this even taller than the drawer. The drawer sits pretty low and when I try to get my wheelbarrow underneath there, it ain't gonna fit. So what I gotta use like a concrete mixing tub, slide that underneath, open it up and spin it, and then all the stuff falls out. I have to bring out my mixing tub, then I have to bag that up or like, you know, transfer that into my wheelbarrow and then wheelbarrow it in my garden. With this one, because it sits so high, you could just basically roll your wheelbarrow underneath here, turn it, and then open this guy up. And then you could empty this out into your wheelbarrow simply and easily, or you could dump it on the ground. Now the other thing I like is that they're using military grade handles. Those of you guys that are in the military, you guys are gonna know these handles. You pull it and then you release it, right? And some of these guys, some people, you know, maybe don't use it right and it doesn't come up, but you basically pull down and lift up. And this guy, even if this guy is full, they've done testing where you could actually have it on the bottom and it's not gonna blow open. Virtually in every other composter I've used by Lifetime, which is my second favorite composters, you know, every single one of them have blown apart, actually. Better not talk too loud, Lifetime's next door. But anyways, they've all blown apart because I get so much weight in there, they blow open and, you know, because it's made in China and maybe not designed and engineered well, it doesn't work that great. This thing is engineered and designed and made in the USA, and they've really done a good job at it. They took my suggestions that I've said to them, and now just seeing this prototype model, I gave them further suggestions, you know, to like put on handles here, because I mean, you could get your fingers in here to spin it, it's not too difficult, but handles just make it easier. Also, like when I opened this guy up, it didn't have like, I didn't see a lot of vent holes in here. There's a few spaces and gaps in between the panels and stuff, but I really would like to see an air hole on the side so we have really good airflow. Airflow is critical to the composting, also making sure you turn your composter each and every day. What other cool features they have? I mean, the other thing, this thing is huge, and I guess it's expected to maybe be out fourth quarter, as I said, the retail price is going to be about $600, maybe around there, plus or minus. And this is going to be the composter to buy if you want something that's going to like be American made and it's going to last a lifetime. They're using the HDPE plastic and they're even going so far to make sure that the coloring in the plastic is food safe and all this kind of stuff. So, I mean, they're really just dotting their P's, crossing their Q's or whatever they say. And this is gonna be simply the best. So I really can't wait to get one, try it out and start using it. And maybe I'll just have a row of these guys in my alleyway, my composter alley, that I have like 10 various different brands of composters that they each, all of them have their problems. And hopefully this one solves all that. So you can check them out at goodideas.com. This product's probably not even on their website yet. And you guys are getting an advanced view. Nobody ever knows about this, you know, unless you've seen it at the show. But yeah, fourth quarter. And as soon as they're out, I'm gonna be sure to get one. I'll assemble it, test it, and let you guys know what I think. So if you're thinking about buying a composter now, I'd encourage you guys to wait a little bit. So now I'm gonna share with you guys the booth of Wonder Soil. The Wonder Soil is manufactured here in Las Vegas. I've actually been to their plant. You can check the link down below. I'm gonna share with you guys the new non-soil based soil products that's now available or soon at Wonder Soil, and why I like this coconut coir material better than all others. So now I want to share with you guys the new products at the Wonder Soil booth, and the reason why I like the Wonder Soil, you know, coconut coir more than the other brands, because they're doing a bit different. This is just not 100% straight coconut coir like you'd buy. This is actually already nutrient enhanced. This actually happens to be their non-organic version. It also has the special space age polymers that can actually help with moisture retention. For those of you guys that want to experiment or may think that's a good thing, you know, I would probably pass on these guys, and I would probably instead go with their organic mix. And their organic mix coconut coir product, you know, has things like the coir, the worm castings, the mycorrhizae, the kelp, also the rock dust included, and also, you know, organic fertilizers inside there. And this is why I like this product, because it's an it's a one-stop shop. Literally, you just buy the coconut coir, you hydrate it, and it has all the different nutrients in there, and maybe just add the compost to it, and you're all set. The other thing that they're doing is that they're innovating. So, you know, a lot of the coconut coir blocks that I've bought in the past, and most of them actually, are like this. And look at it on the inside. This is one solid block. It's like a brick. You could probably build a house or something with this. But it's one solid brick. Now, the challenge with this is that when you go to soak it, if you just soak this whole block in, you know, like a concrete mixing tub, it's not really going to fully expand. You need to, like, sit there with a freaking stupid, like, shovel and break it up, or like rip it off with your hands if you're like Arnold Schwarzenegger, like hit it with your head. It doesn't break up, and it takes excessive work to try to like get it to come apart and to hydrate so that you guys could use it. What Wonder Soil is doing, they're actually now selling the coir sheets, which is like super intelligent, because look at this. On the side shot there, I don't know if you guys could see that, they're sheets, and there's like there's two halves in this pack, and then there's like a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. There's 10 individual sheets. So instead of having you guys break it up and waste your valuable time, they just give you these sheets, and they basically come like this. Because these are not super wide, you could easily dunk these in a 5-gallon bucket, hydrated with water. They're gonna fluff up and be ready for you guys to use without like hitting with a shovel or a pickaxe or whatever you guys gotta do, right? Saves you guys a lot of time. Plus, as I said, fully infused with the nutrients. Now, if this wasn't enough, Wonder Soil is also taking it to the next level. And if you don't want to buy something totally compacted like this, they have, you know, not fully expanded but compressed mixtures with some other ingredients in there that are actually quite interesting. So they have like a wide range of products, and maybe in my opinion, too many things, because people get confused on actually which one to buy. So let's go ahead and head over and share with you guys some other new Wonder Soil products that can help you guys live a more ecological and sustainable life. So besides all the soil products Wonder Soil has, they have this new product here. It's called the Wonder Sorb. 2-in-1 oil and liquid absorbent. Turn oil into soil. Do you guys believe that? Turn oil into soil? Well, think about it. When they had that big Gulf oil spill, right? I mean, they put all those dispersant nasty chemicals in there, but what really broke down that oil? It was the bacteria and the, you know, microbiome, that basically the bacteria eats the oil. I mean, it's petroleum, it comes from the earth, right? It's natural, except when they put all those extra additives in there. And this is how nature works. So what they got this oil sorb. I've shown videos in the past where they use coconut coir to like absorb it, to like get it out, like, you know, using kitty litter on that, you know, on that spill on the freeway. But now you could use a coconut coir, but they made it even better, because most of the other coconut coir products on the market are not using compressed coir in their product. They are using compressed coir, which actually is more like a sponge than just the standard, you know, fine particulate coir products. So that makes it even better. Now this oil sorb is a 2-in-1. This also contains another fiber known as canaf, and I've had other videos at this event showing canaf fiber grow pads, for instance. And what you do is you literally just take a little container, right? And this is just for demonstration. We got some motor oil, or in this case, antifreeze. You're just gonna pour it in there. And whatever you do, don't let your pets drink this stuff. Definitely not good. We're gonna go ahead and take a scoop of their new oil absorb stuff. And look, we're gonna pour it in there so you guys can see it. And shake it around, and look at that. You guys can see instantly, real time on the camera, that this stuff, basically without even me like mixing it up or anything, just got all absorbed. Now, if this were some kind of motor oil or, you know, natural oil, hopefully without all these added chemicals in it, this stuff would not only absorb, but now in the canaf, there's a special bacteria that basically eat up the oil. After it does that, then you could actually use this to grow plants in. Now, I still wouldn't be growing vegetables in, but you know, yeah, you could use this. It would basically let it break down. You could use this underneath your big trees, and it'd be fine to use. So that's what they're telling me. I gotta see the studies and research on this, but I believe it. This is how nature works. You know, I think a better thing besides just the canaf and having bacteria is adding specific other bacteria in here that are known to digest oil. So yeah, this is the future of, like, you know, solving man's problems is through natural plant-based materials. Now, if you guys wanna grow some plants and some vegetable, healthy vegetable plants, let me show you guys some other products they have here at Wondersoil. So better than the blocks that I just showed you guys, I like these products a lot more. This is basically their bag product, and I think it's time that they had one of these products. Inside this bag is compressed coconut coir, so it's compressed in a small little bits, so this allows them to fit more in than if you bought the hydrated coir. But also, it's pre-impregnated with other ingredients. So for example, this one has the coir and the pit moss. No, not peat moss, it's pit moss. If you guys watched the Shark Tank, the pit moss was actually on the Shark Tank. Basically, it's made out of the newspaper. So, you know, that's newspaper bits with the coconut coir, and maybe they put some other ingredients in there. This increases water retention to the roots. Now, besides just the pit moss, they got the coir and the vermiculite mixture. Enhances moisture and nutrients, and this also has extra added silicon. The silicon is the backbone of the plants, very important. And I was told this is actually a plant available silicon. They also have a core and purelite product. They have also another really cool product, the core and biomass. So what the biomass is in here, you know, some of the hotels on the Las Vegas Strip actually have machines that take their food waste, fruits and vegetable waste, they put it in the machine and it super dehydrates it into little pellets. And you know, this is the biomass, or basically dehydrated vegetable matter, that you basically put into the soil, they break down, and then it'll actually act as fertilizer for your plants. So they have that. So, I mean, they have so many different things. And if you said, John, which one should I buy? Well, you know, get the one that's gonna be best for you. Hopefully pretty soon I'll be working with the Wondersoil company again to make my own mixture of the coir and vermiculite with the worm castings, the rock dust, and some other organic nutrients. And then what I foresee is, like, you know how I like to recommend that Mel's mix, or Mel Bartholomew's raised bed mix. It's 1/3 compost, 1/3 coconut coir or peat moss, and 1/3 vermiculite. I'm gonna make a mixture here that's gonna have the coconut coir and the vermiculite, as well as the other nutrients I like, such as the Worm Go Plus worm castings and the rock dust and other stuff, so that you'll be able to add this to a locally sourced compost or stuff you guys made yourself, and have your own raised bed mix. Or you could even just use this to add fertility to your garden. Everything they do is pretty great, but you know, I'm sure I could dial it in with a specific recipe. So be sure to click that subscribe button right down below for when I'm doing that real soon. Of course, also, they're growing lots of different sprouts and microgreens. I know many microgreens growers using their Wonder Soil to grow it, with amazing results. And maybe one of these days they're gonna come out with a super microgreens grower kit as well. If you wanna learn more about the Wondersoil company, you can check them out at wondersoil.com. So now I wanna share with you guys the next booth, and it's actually a multi-dimensional booth, because there's four different small businesses sharing their wares with you guys. And it's the Plant Picket. It's sticking up for your garden, little plant tags. They got the Groy Olla, which is an olla, which is basically a clay pot that you put, sink in your soil. It'll water your plants without any kind of irrigation system. Then they got the Sweet Seed, which is actually a natural hummingbird nectar and other nectars for other birds and butterflies and whatnot without any kind of like red dye number 40. We don't feed that to us. Why do we feed that to our hummingbirds and all this other stuff and all these chemical additives in that food? They also have other nutrients in there so that your hummingbirds could get healthier. What better thing to do? And then they got the Rain Reserve, which is American-made products so that you can harvest your own rainwater to water your plants. So let's go ahead and check out the two vendors in this booth that I like the best. So first I'm gonna show the guys the Rain Reserve rain barrel, and it's in the picture here. Like, John, there ain't no rain barrel in that picture, man. What you talking about, Willis? All right, so this is a rain barrel right here. Check it out. You can't even tell it's a rain barrel because it could fit into your decor, your design, and even fit underneath, you know, your wooden deck, and you could store water underneath your deck in one of these because it's no, you're no longer confined to a rain barrel. What it is basically specially engineered plastic panels that can, you know, take the water weight, and inside there's these basically these tubular water bladders that hold the water. So you could catch the water, it goes in here, you could hold the water, and then use it to water your garden. Super intelligent. And that's one of them. We'll cover some of the products in a minute. And then also you guys can see this little garden behind me, which is really cool because it's in one of those pallets, you know, a pallet box. And they got plants with the plant tags, and they got the Oyas. So you water the Oya, and then basically the water seeps out of the ceramic and then waters the surrounding area so that you don't have to put in a drip irrigation system. And this is how, like, you know, the, some of the cultures around the world watered their plants when they didn't have hoses and drip irrigation. They had ceramic pots that they would go up and fill every day. The water gets released at a slow rate so all your plants could grow and thrive. I guess next, let's go ahead and take a look at some of the Rain Reserve products and see the products that make this rain barrel happen. So now I'm going to share with you guys the Rain Reserve rain barrel. And besides just having the rain barrel kits here, you know, which comes in a box like this, this is the whole rain barrel. This guy will store 50 gallons. They also have a 100-gallon kit. And the cool thing is, if you don't like the shape of these guys, you could design your own kit and you could buy these parts individually to put it underneath your deck, make a whole wall of these guys. You know, you could go too high, no problem, without any kind of like structural support, or tie it down to a fence or a wall. But if you want to go three or four high, you should probably definitely have some bracing so that it actually didn't get too top heavy and, you know, knock over somebody. But yeah, these kits are definitely, I like these guys because they look nice. They don't just look like a rain barrel. I know a lot of you guys are eco and all this stuff. You guys care more about the price than how it looks, but I know a lot of you guys might have some money and care more about how it looks. Of course, you can just buy a standard 55-gallon drum and make sure you get one that wasn't filled previously with oil and all this stuff. Make sure it had some food-grade materials in there. Buy it off Craigslist for 20 bucks, 55-gallon drum, and then you're gonna convert it into a rain barrel. Now, the challenge with that is that you're gonna need all these different plumbings and fittings and things to take the water off your gutter and get it in the rain barrel. Well, guess what? Rain Reserve designs, manufactures these products in the United States so you guys could do just that. Here's one of the things they've designed. Okay, pretend this was like 55 gallons, but it's just, that's the miniature version, right? You guys drill the hole in there and you wanna be able to hook up your hose into that. And normally you gotta be able to get your hand down in there to put a washer in the back of it and screw it in. You know, say you wanna use an old propane tank that doesn't hold propane anymore, but it'd be good enough to hold water, or, you know, an oil drum, right? That has like a little bunghole at the top, and you can't get like this thing all the way down there and line it up to get it going. That's a pain in the butt. So they actually have this kit that they designed and make in America. You just put the hole in your rain barrel. You take this and stick it in from the outside. It's like this rubber-like material, right? You got it in there. Then you put the fitting in there, and you screw that fitting in. If you hold the tab here, you screw that in, and as you're screwing it in, guess what? This rubber thing expands out, and basically it makes its own gasket and makes its own seal. So the most important part of this thing is you gotta drill the proper size hole. If your hole's too big, this won't expand out enough to fill the gaps. And once you got this in there, it's gonna hold the water in, it's not gonna leak, and then you have a spigot on here that you could tap off and turn your hose on, you know, to get the water out. And that's just like, you could buy this component like separately. They got the smaller version, which I recommend. You know, this is one's pretty much, you know, don't get it. Get the one with the larger diameter. It's gonna be definitely better for you. And you know, you gotta drill a bigger hole. So that's a larger one. You guys saw just a smaller one. Now, of course you could buy these parts separately, but if you're installing, like, if you buy one of those, 55-gallon drums off Craigslist, you're gonna need a whole kit. So this is the kit you guys wanna get. This is a complete diverter kit. This you plug in and set up to your downspout. And then in addition to that, besides the downspout tie-in, you also have that little adapter thing I showed you guys. So you could actually put that bung, so you could actually put a hose onto it. In addition, it has a connector tubing, so you could actually link two of these guys up with one kit. And this kit is proudly manufactured in America. This is not some cheap Chinese stuff that I've seen before. You know, if I was gonna be installing some barrels and I want a kit, this is the kit I would definitely buy. So yeah, they got a lot of cool products, all made in America. And because you guys are my viewers and you guys have watched to this point in the video, I've negotiated really hard to get you guys the best pricing online, best delivered pricing online. Not only will the GYG 2016 coupon get you guys 15% off anything you purchase at Rain Reserve, it'll also get you guys free shipping as well. So this blows the pants off Amazon.com and other websites. So buy from them directly, support an American-owned company. And yeah, let them know that you want to save water to conserve nature's most, one of nature's most precious resources. So now I want to share with you guys the Groyoyas, I can't say that. I had a speech therapist in elementary school. Anyways, here it is. It's kind of buried in their bed here. And since I bought them originally, actually, they were available at Costco, and they didn't have a top. And I'm like, man, these things are super lame, dude. You're gonna fill the water, especially like in Las Vegas, where it's like a dry climate. I mean, yeah, some of the water is gonna go through the pores, but dude, the rest is gonna like go up into the atmosphere. Like, I'm making rain clouds with my Groyoya. What's up? So I'm glad they really came out with this silicone plug. Otherwise, I wouldn't be sharing this with you guys right now. You basically put it right in the top, and so now the water's not gonna evaporate out the top. It's gonna basically come out the pores like it should. So the Groyoya, they probably have like the biggest and widest level of distribution in the United States that I've seen, because a lot of people, they just will not ship the Oyas because they are made out of ceramic. I mean, if you drop this on the concrete, it's probably gonna shatter. So, you know, people don't want to ship this stuff because they break a lot, but they've redesigned their packaging, so it's pretty durable. Hey, let's see if it, like, I could throw this up and it's gonna break. All right, man, watch this. Look, man, I threw that up and it hit the ground. Let's see if it broke. It didn't break. Oops, it broke. Yeah, so don't drop these, be very careful with them. But in the packaging, they're pretty secure. So let me go ahead and share with you guys some more information about the Groyoya. So I really like the Oyas, you know, especially if you don't have hoses and drip irrigation system. It really makes it really simple to get your plants watered. Now, you know, they have recommendations on the box, like maybe like they say one of our large ones will feed a whole 4-foot circular raised bed. I don't know that I'd go that far. I'd always want to plant my plants maybe within a foot of the Oya. So if you had a 4-foot square raised bed, I might get like four of them just to make sure. One of the things I'll be doing soon, hopefully, is supplementing my drip irrigation with the Oyas in certain places where I may not be getting enough water. I think they are fabulous, old school technology that we can now take advantage of in the modern world. If you want to learn more about the Groyoyas, you can check them out at Groyoya. I'll put a link down below for you guys. And make sure you use the coupon code GYG once again to get the best deal delivered on the Groyoya in the USA. So if you guys are gardening indoors and you don't have a space outdoors, or you want to grow indoors in the wintertime, the next product is a product you will want to buy. It's an all-in-one product. You know, I've seen a lot of these, you know, inside gardening things. You could buy like the frame, and then you gotta buy the drippers, you gotta buy this, you gotta buy that, you gotta buy all these parts separately, you gotta buy the lights, you gotta buy the controllers. This is called the Eco Garden House, made in the USA, all the major components, and it's a one-stop shop. So you buy this, yeah, it's gonna be a little bit spendy, it's about $1,000, but you buy this, you set it up, and you'll be able to grow plants year-round inside your house, inside your garage, wherever you want to. Yeah, I wouldn't put this outside. Anyways, let's go ahead and share with you guys this Eco Garden House and show you guys why it's so valuable. All right, so the first thing about the Eco Garden House is that it has lots of lighting. It has like these fluorescent lighting that I'm underneath that I'm almost getting blinded by on the top. It also has them on the sides. So this is gonna give your plants the lights they need to create chlorophyll and flourish. Whether you're growing, you know, herbs, medicinal herbs, vegetables, you know, fruits like tomatoes, this will grow it. Now, besides just the lighting, they got a built-in controller. I don't know if you guys can see that here. This is the controller that controls the lights. It controls the lights to come on and off at the cycles you set it. It also has built-in fans, so it's gonna provide the ventilation and keep the temperature where you need it to be as well. Now, besides just that, which is really cool, it has an easy plastic frame that you guys could set up and build yourself. It comes in a box like about as wide as a thing, maybe about that tall, with this all compressed down so it's easily shippable. All the plastic made and molded in the United States. And the most important part of this is if you're gonna put this in your house, especially the second floor of your house, you don't want it leaking everywhere, man. You get dry rot and mold, black mold, all this stuff. Not worth it. But they've designed this so that it will not leak water. And furthermore, this timer also controls the irrigation system that I'm standing on. So let me guys go ahead and show you guys that next. So now what we're looking at is the floor of the Eco Garden House. And you know, besides having the house or the little greenhouse thing around it, you know, down at the bottom here they have a little like tray. So if water should leak, it's going to be stuck in this, so it's not going to leak out. But furthermore, even more intelligent, they basically have a big water bladder. Each side holds 33 gallons of water. One side's for the fresh water and one side's for the gray water. If you don't want to use the gray water side, you could also use this for fresh water. You're just going to have to set up the configuration a little bit differently over here. This side, basically, they have the drip emitters coming out, and they have tubing going to the different pots. So it's all set up to water automatically so that you don't have to. And then once the water drains out, if you overwater, it's going to basically funnel down these channels in the bladder, and then it's going to go to this side. Which is the gray water or wastewater. And yeah, so that's how it's not gonna leak. Literally, it has its own water compartment. You could fill up your nutrient solution. If you need to clean that, you could use an enzymatic cleaner in there. Yeah, all in one. You could grow anything in the privacy of your own home. I really like this setup a lot. I really like that they designed and manufactured the majority of this in the United States, aside from some of the components they have to source from outside the United States. I mean, I really like that it's an all-in-one system so that it makes gardening and growing food or medicinal herbs or herbs simple for you guys. If you want to learn more about this, you can visit them at ecogardenhouse.com. Yeah, I'm glad they have this, and yeah, they've really thought about and engineered this properly. So now I'm in the new products area, and I always love coming to the new products area because I never know what I'm gonna find. There's a few products in here, but I'm pretty much only gonna share with you guys one of them today. And it's right here behind me. It's the Downpipe Garden. It's a product designed and made in Australia. So this is the first time it's even being seen in the US. So let's go ahead and check it out and how you guys could grow food on your downpipe. Amazing. So have you guys ever looked at your downpipe that's like sitting on the front of your house and you're like, man, that thing's ugly. I don't wanna like see that downpipe, and you don't know what to do. Maybe you put one of those chains down that kind of like dribbles the water out. Those look even better. But what's even better than that is this guy. This is the downpipe garden. Now you can grow food on your downpipe or any other plants, flowers, whatever you wanna grow. And actually that's how this product was invented. You know, the designer that I met myself, you know, is a builder, and he saw that somebody put a downspout on the front of the house or in the front of a building in Australia, and he's like, man, that's lazy, and like, that doesn't look good, and you shouldn't do that. It should be on the side or the back so you don't see it, right? In America, they're on the front of the buildings all the time. I never even dawned on it if it looks ugly. That's just a downspout. They painted the same color as the house. Blends in, right? But what better thing to do with your downspout than to, you know, grow on it? So what they did was they made this kit, and it just, it's really simple, and you don't need to drill into your house or, you know, use a screw gun or do any of this stuff to grow food. And this is really good for you guys that don't own tools like the install I just did. So all that's in here is just a few things. You got a few pots. Each kit comes with the two little pots here, and then you just got these guys. This basically will attach to your downspout, not with any screws or nails or anything. Just the standard zip ties, super intelligent. So let's check out how this works. What you're gonna do is you're gonna go over to your downspout, and they got it already set up here. We're gonna go ahead and take this guy off, and look at this. You take this bracket here, you set it on your downspout, and then you take the super oversized zip tie and you put it in the little groove there that they designed, and then you basically zip tie it on and pull it tight. You pull it taut, and then it's just gonna sit up. And this is designed and engineered so that it's gonna hold the weight of the pot. Now, don't fill this pot up with like sand that weighs a lot. You're gonna wanna have a nice fluffy potting soil mixture that has lots of vermiculite in there so it's not too heavy. And also it's the vermiculite and maybe some coconut coir also gonna help retain the water, so you're gonna be a higher level of success. And then you basically have this set up, you have the framing on, then you just take this pot, you just put it in here like this. just snaps in. And then here's the cool thing. Say the downspout's coming up from the top and it goes right over this, drill a hole in the downspout, and then you could take like, just like something as simple as a zip tie, put it down through that hole, and as the water comes down the downspout, it'll drip out that hole through the zip tie to the top one, and then once this gets water, then there's little holes in the one, above it that's gonna drop down to the one below it and water that too. Now, I personally would not rely on the rain to water my garden. I would personally also install some kind of drip irrigation system that went up to the top one that would water it regularly. And then once you overwater this a little bit, it'll drip down. And even better yet than just watering once at the top, have drippers go into each one so that each one gets watered consistently the amount of water you need to be successful in growing your food. Now, the cool thing is if there's a cold spell coming in or something like that, and you're like, man, we're gonna get a frost for a day or two and my plants are sensitive, all you gotta do is come outside and you could pick this up, clip them off. Clip them off and take them inside. So you could protect your plants from the winter. Furthermore, if you're planting out your plants, you could take this off, put it on a countertop, on a bench, plant everything out, and then take it out, and then put it on the unit and assemble it in. So you don't have to like sit there on a ladder planting your stuff out. Don't do that, man, that can be very dangerous. And I also encourage you guys to start these guys low and go high, and don't go too high, so you could minimize your time on ladders. I fell off a ladder once and it was not fun. I don't encourage that for anybody. The downpipe garden is not yet available in the USA. This is the first time it's being shown. It's available for you guys that are lucky to live in Australia. It is available there now. That's where it's designed and made. Hopefully pretty soon in the US they'll be picking it up. That's why they're at this show, to figure all this stuff out. And the price in the US anyways will be about around $30 plus or minus. So that's an amazing price for two little garden kits that you can, assemble, put on your wall without any tools. If you want to learn more about the downpipe garden, you want to visit the website downpipegarden.com.au. So the hardware show is coming to the end. Everybody's packing up and going home. And the cool thing when I come to these shows and I work with a couple of the different vendors, they give me sample products to try. So this may be future episodes for you guys. I got a really cool cloning system, 40 Clone Sites Pro Series from OxyClone, that hydro farm one you guys saw earlier. And then, for a lot of you guys, I recommend you guys get something like this. This is a active air two-way meter. This is a moisture sensor. It'll tell you guys when you need to water your plants, because I know a lot of you guys have no clue and you guys tend to overwater. It's not good to overwater or underwater. It's best to get the appropriate amount of water. And with a little meter like this, you guys could do it. These are available at a local hydroponic store near you. I mean, I got a lot of other cool stuff that I'm gonna get to play with really soon. Many of the products I may even actually be making videos about. Hopefully you guys enjoy this episode, learn about some of the new products that can help you guys grow more food, clone your plants, grow lettuce indoors. I mean, I gotta say, like, the products I like the most this show, let's see, okay. Number one, I liked the microbes, of course. What is it, Garden Treasures Microbes. I wanna really see how that works. Like, I have strong faith that's gonna work, and hopefully my garden gets better, right? If my garden gets better because of those microbes, then I know they work. And if nothing really gets better, then I know that maybe I got good microbes already. So I guess we'll see. And maybe I'll do pot tests. I got a bunch of samples. Maybe I'll do one pot with the stuff and one pot without, and we'll see the differences in root growth. That'd be really cool. I also liked the, Good Ideas, Composter. They actually took my suggestions to make a better mousetrap. This is what every company in this industry should do, and in every industry, always improve things instead of keep things a status quo, like, in my opinion, many American car companies these days. Except, actually, the Tesla car company. They're making shit better. I appreciate that. But yeah, and bringing products to market that allow you guys to grow more food easily at home, even if you never did it, even if they're overpriced, like those seed mats that I didn't particularly care for. But if you like this episode, and all this, and it was valuable to you, hey, please give me a thumbs up to let me know. Please do that, because if I get enough thumbs up, I'll be sure to come back next year and make another video sharing with you guys the newest products, because there's always new products. Unfortunately, products are not going to go away anytime soon, and they're here to help us and can help you guys too. And as much as a lot of the stuff in here I would never buy and it's junk, there's some products that I really like, and those are the ones that I shared with you guys today. So anyways, like this video if you liked it. Be sure to check my past episodes. I have over 1,100 episodes now sharing with you guys how you guys can grow your own food. I also have links in the description on the past videos I've made at the National Hardware Show. You guys could get up to date with all the latest and products that I really like. And also be sure to click that subscribe button right down below so you don't miss my exciting episodes coming out about every 3 to 4 days, because you never know where I'll show up or what you're going to learn on one of my shows. So once again, my name is John Kohler with growingyourgreens.com. We'll see you next time. And until then, remember, keep on growing. All right, this is John Kohler with growingyourgreens.com. Bit of another exciting episode for you. I'm still here in Austin, Texas. And today I have the pleasure of being at M.E. Cunningham School. And this is an elementary school.